Greetings, Eric Bakker, New Zealand naturopath. Going to today talk about really the connection between bladder infection, urinary infections, and yeast infections or candida problem. Many people I've seen over the years have complained about vaginal yeast infections, but also seeing thousands of people with urinary tract infections and kidney infections, all kinds of infections involving the urogenital tract. So if we have a look typically at urinary tract infection, one of the most common denominators is E. coli, Escherichia coli, or a bacteria that commonly lives in the digestive tract. It can easily get in through the urethra, particularly in women, because it's a lot shorter than in men, and cause a UTI, or urinary tract infection. There are other kinds of bugs that can affect the urinary tract as well. Yeast can easily get into the urethra, especially around that area there for women. It's much more common than it is for men. And it can often again be transferred from the rectal area because about 1 in 4 people have got candida commonly living in the digestive system. So it's not hard for candida to get in around the urethra area. And it can ascend. It can cause problems in the ureters and in the bladder. I've even seen and heard of people getting fungal kidney infections. I mean, there are different types of funguses that can affect, or fungi, I should say, that can affect the urinary tract. A more rare form of yeast affecting the urinary tract is aspergillosis, but there are many other forms that can potentially affect it as well. So sometimes cultures will pick them up, sometimes they won't pick them up. So yes, it can occur. So I've written an extensive page on urinary tract infection on ericbakker.com. You can have a look at that. Very long page. It explains about E. coli, explains about the best treatment for UTIs. It's a huge amount of information on that page. But it's not that hard to distinguish between often a bacterial infection and a candida infection involving the urinary tract. We tend to look for, particularly if it affects the vaginal area, look for discharge and itch. And cultures will often pick this up, particularly in the early stages. A culture will really reveal what the problem is in this area. Women on immunosuppressive drugs are very much more common to getting this problem. Also older women where estrogen levels drop off, because estrogen has a big effect on the integrity of the urinary tract. And as the levels decline, they can be more prone towards infections. And women can get urinary tract infections at different stages of their lives for different reasons as well. But the connection is certainly there between candida and a urinary tract infection. Absolutely. So if in doubt, get it checked out and get some cultures done to find out what's wrong and then get the appropriate treatment. Thanks for tuning in.